It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1607, recorded Wednesday, January 25th, 2017. From OjO to OJ. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, it's the end of January. We still have some gadgets from CES, but the last gadget from my parents. All coming up next. Also, your letters next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the master of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir, and you?
I am doing good myself. It's been a fine week, and getting ready to head off to a convention.
Yes, why are we meeting a day early? Why are we doing this?
So I'm going to PAX. I always feel like it's PAX, Penny Arcade Expo, and there's three of them in the United States that I tend to go to.
And PAX strangely, they're all on the same day.
I know. Yes. I wish, right? Just go
no,
to one
no, go ahead. So.
So they're all over the country. There's one south in San Antonio. There's one east in Boston, which will happen in about 2 months, and then there's one which is called West now. It was originally called Prime, but it's called West, and that is in Seattle, Washington. And there is rumors of a North in Canada 1 year, but who knows when or where that will happen. That doesn't exist yet. But yeah, so that at least three times a year I go to a PAX, and it's all about video games. There's a lot of developers there. It's, you know, a convention, so you're going to have also merchandise and, you know, cool swag to buy and meeting up with people. There's a lot of big companies throw big events that are at, you know, they have DJs and a party space, and it's a lot of fun to go. And so anyway, that's where I'm headed to.
Wow.
Tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Off to San Antonio.
You know, I thought swag was free stuff.
Oh.
You said swag you can buy.
Yeah.
Am I mistaken? Swag is...
Swag is free stuff, but it's also just, like, I think it's just, like, paraphernalia, basically.
Paraphernalia. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think. I don't know. Can correct me if I'm wrong, chat room. To me, like, I might have a lot of... Let's say I was into a TV show. So I have a bunch of TV show swag. It's just stuff, really, in my opinion.
Swag plus.
Swag plus, right.
Right. Well, that's all right. Well, because tomorrow I'm going to the boat show and I'll get a catalog. So there you go.
Oh, nice. Nice, yeah.
Not quite.
Well, the swag isn't, yeah, I guess, yeah, at this convention, swag's not free.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, swag prime. Maybe I'm the only one who says swag. It's merch, yeah. Apparently I've been saying it wrong. Define swag. Yeah, everyone's saying merch in my Twitch chat. I have it wrong. You know, this is the problem with a inconsistent narrator, is you never know what he's saying.
Well, that's okay. That's the charm of the Giz Wiz.
We don't have to be right.
We don't have to be right.
We embrace fake news, really. We embrace it. No, I'm just kidding. So anyway, I have a lot of fun at PAX this next weekend. And a lot of times I'll be working, and I have to do interviews and look at video games and record a whole bunch of stuff, and I'm actually not doing that this PAX, so I'm happy about that.
Oh, great, great.
Yeah, I'm just going to hang out with people. With that, I guess let's jump into the show.
So let's jump in. This is going to be our final stuff from CES. We're going to start out with a pretty nifty looking scooter if you're looking for a neat way to travel.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. I'm walking by and I hear a scooter that's playing music. So I guess we could call this the first Bluetooth scooter?
Well, it is the first with a dual speaker system. Okay. That's high fidelity waterproof speakers that are integrated, syncs to your phone.
Okay, but that's not the main reason for this, okay? Is it the OJ? The OJO.
It's the OJO, which by the way means rebirth. So that's not where we came up with the name, but it means rebirth. So this is what we call the rebirth of transportation.
Okay, so an urban scooter. We're doing some slick camera work here. I think Michael Summer is pushing against me. I thought I was doing terrible things.
I think Michael actually kind of liked pushing against me.
Yeah, I think it is. Okay, so this guy fold up?
No, and the reason for that is everything in the marketplace has been toy-like. It's foldables and very, you know, short riding, scooter type stuff. This is more, what we wanted to develop was a piece of real and smart transportation that would be something for everyday use in lieu of driving a car, whether you're going to school, you're going to the market, wherever you're going, and it's totally stable. So
I have an idea that this man works for this company. It's just a wild, crazy guess. So is this out now?
It is out now. Yeah. It's just, we're just shipping actually with Amazon is our first, that was our first huge order. We're just taking care of that now, which were close to 1,000 OJOs that they ordered at one time. So,
okay. And the price point?
$19.99.
And wait, a couple of other questions. The speed?
Speed is 20 miles an hour, which keeps it, by the way, that's the horn. It keeps it in the bike lane, so you don't need to get a license. 16 and under, for example, in the state of California, you wouldn't need a helmet, but we encourage people to have the helmet. But one of the things that really makes this neat, the onboard charger, that's really amazing.
Right, that's very good.
Because you have distance anxiety.
Okay, now, that's the next question, distance.
Okay, distance, it'll go 25 to 27 miles on a charge, and it actually, wherever you go to charge it, is only as close as the nearest 110 outlet.
So it's a regular extension cord outlet.
It's built in.
Oh, it's built in, okay.
Just like a vacuum.
All right, we're going to see this because, I like this. All right.
It goes right back into its little...
Okay, and many, many different colors.
Seven different colors, street art, graphite. We have a sky blue. We got an amazing bright orange.
Okay. This is it. This is really good for urban travel. And it's green, right? No emissions, no gas. I like this. OJ, the model, do you have a model?
Yeah, it's an OJO 500.
So it's OJO 500. OJO. Next year we'll come here and it'll be the 900. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I would Zoom, but I don't want to kill roughly 500 people. Bye.
So the OJO scooter.
OJO.
The biggest thing is $2,000. That seems.
Does that seem like a lot of money? You know, I've never priced a scooter. But, you know, after coming from the bike show where bikes were $5,000 and $8,000, $2,000 to me didn't seem like a lot, but I really don't know the marketplace.
You know, that's a good question. And it seems to me quite expensive.
Okay.
If I was, you know, and I'm imagining this is for someone who might live in a big urban environment, a major metropolitan city, and this would replace a car.
Someone who wants to sit.
And someone who wants to sit. Now, in their video, it didn't seem like there was a lot of people using this sit feature. It looked like a lot of people were standing. I could buy up to five.
The seat,
oh, look at that. Go ahead.
The seat is removable.
Gotcha.
And he said it holds up to 300 pounds, which is evidently very unusual in the scooter market for a scooter that can handle a 300-pound person. So that's probably why they have the seat, because a 300-pound person probably doesn't want to stand up.
Exactly, right.
Someone's saying is the weatherproof. I know that the speakers are waterproof. I assume that there's some amount of waterproof in the scooter itself. But I, as I said, I've never ever ridden an electric scooter.
Right.
I would like to.
Seems interesting. I keep kind of looking at products nowadays as like, do I really think that they're viable out in the market? And I guess there's a difference between, you know, viable and a success. You could have a product that isn't the next Furby and is still a success.
Yeah, absolutely right. Absolutely right. Also, it was strange because when he said that Amazon bought 1,000 of them.
I know.
I thought Amazon didn't buy anything.
I didn't think they, I mean, I know that there's a few things that are in Amazon warehouses that they do purchase, but
I
would not have thought that they would have put in an order for 1,000, $2,000 scooters.
Unless they were able to buy them for...
Right, exactly.
Like $500.
$500, right, exactly. Right.
You know, maybe something like that.
I mean, maybe they bought that for their campus. Amazon have them at their, you know, who knows? He said just Amazon bought them. Who knows?
Jackson says maybe they just bought them for the warehouse.
Yeah, exactly. To scoot around all the warehouses. I think that there's a few things that jump out at me that is very good. The range at 25 miles. I don't think that I'd want to sit on a scooter that went, 16 miles an hour?
20, maximum of 20.
Yeah, I don't think I'd want to stand or sit on the scooter for over an hour to get to a place. So I think that range is absolutely phenomenal.
I like that plug out, that cord.
Me
that
too.
Is in the scooter, so you just pull up to any AC outlet, zip the cord out, and charge it. That, I think, was a good plus.
Yeah, I agree. Now, do you remember how long it takes to charge? Because that cord is just so convenient.
Yeah, I did not ask.
You can take it anywhere. And then I do like that they decided to go for the design of it not being, you know, toy-like, not being too foldable. That seems like it adds quite a lot of sturdiness to it. And the LCD at the top seemed very, very professional.
Yeah, a little professional LED screen. I thought that was good, too. And you have your integrated speakers, although I think the integrated waterproof speakers were an option. I'm not 100% sure. And there's also an available security system they can install. So there are a lot of options. Also, you always know when I said to the guy, I think this guy works for the company, is, you know, people who work for the company as opposed to people who they just hired for the show, is you say to someone who they just hired for the show, does it come in colors? And they say, oh, yeah, 7 colors. When you get the person who works for the company, you say, does it come in colors? They go, raspberry ripple.
Right, exactly.
Black sequins.
Right.
Cloud white.
Purple mountain majesty.
Yes, exactly. Exact. Super duper yellow.
Yes.
No answer is just an answer. Every answer is a copy line.
Yes.
I think it said it could go up 15% grade hills. For those of you who measure hills,
right,
that you go up.
Man, I have this
15%
one, yeah, 20% grade hill near me that I just can't get over.
Oh, yeah, they're going to have to find a shortcut.
Ah, man.
You can go 3/4 of the way up that hill with your 15%.
You can go 15% up a 100% grade hill. That's
there you go.
It's quite nice. That's very nice.
Yeah, and the little dashboard will tell you exactly all that.
Right.
Anyway, if you're looking for a scooter, it's something to know about.
Right. I'm watching a video about how this thing is made, I think. I'm not exactly certain. They're building something in front of me. This is on their website.
Oh, this might be the battery, right?
It looks like the battery, but then they keep adding on to it. Like, okay, well, then that goes in a little box, and then a little circuit on top, and then some more wires, and then we're going to put a base on that. I don't know. This is a very extensive video just for a battery. I guess it is just the battery.
I guess it is. Well, the battery, wow. The battery in the brains of the scooter looked like was in there.
Onboard charging system. That's why I watched that video. I can't find really anything about exactly how long it takes to charge, but the convenience of it having just a normal plug is incredible, because you can go literally anywhere and there's going to be a plug somewhere for you to plug in.
Yep.
Very, very yep. convenient.
No, yeah. A lot of places you have to take the battery out and up to your office.
Right.
And need a charger. This is just the wall. The wall is your charger.
Wall.
We should let's sell them that slogan. The wall is your charger.
Do you remember? I'm also trying to figure out how heavy it is. Could you take this up a flight of stairs?
Oh, that's you know, thought. I do not know that.
Anyway, I think that it's a nice scooter from what I see. $2,000 to me seems steep. I basically couldn't imagine anyone in their San Francisco apartment being able to drop $2,000, at least the people that I hung out with in San Francisco.
All right. Well, that's why you moved, isn't it?
Exactly, right. In Dallas, yeah. Everyone can afford one of these scooters, absolutely. So anyway, very, very interesting. And they said that you can install a security system as well. Okay, the OJO. Scooter, you can find out more at ojoscooter.com.
.com, exactly. Someone's Eternal Nazi said, oh no, Flipper said the price is so steep, the scooter could not go up it.
That's true.
Anyway, okay, so on to item two. So this is kind of fun. Wearable technology, one of the buzzwords at CES, you know, three dozen fitness bands, but only one wearable airbag.
Ooh.
And before they see the video, I'll tell you a funny story about this. It was not only at their booth in Eureka Park, but CES had the Best of Innovations Pavilion, where they selected items that were outstanding in 2017. And they had one of these airbag jackets. And these two guys were looking at it, whispering to each other, looking at it, whispering, walking around it. And I kept saying, I know one of those guys. And I finally walked around so I could see his badge. And it was David Copperfield.
Oh, what?
Yes. I said, oh, my gosh. No wonder I know that face.
And
I've
seen
thinking,
his poster everywhere.
Yes, exactly. Especially in Vegas. And I'm thinking, they're thinking we might have a use for this
right.
in something we do. So let's just have a little, it's like 40-second video. So basically they make jackets that become inflatable airbags when the computer in the jacket realizes you're in a position you should normally not be in. It self-inflates. So it's a silent video. So you can just run the video, Chad. And yeah, it's right there. And so you'll see the guy go over and it inflates, but then they do it in slow motion. So now he's almost upside down. You see the jacket inflate?
Interesting.
And he'll do it again. It's normal. It's normal. And it just inflated.
Weird.
So the object here is that when you come down, you'll land on this air pack.
Wow. There has to be ton of smarts in that to get that right.
Yes. Well, this is not inexpensive. Now, the company is called In and Motion, and they have been building these for professionals. But now they thought they would come out with a consumer model, and they said it would probably cost about $800. And assuming you didn't wreck it in whatever mishap you had, you would just replace the air cartridges and use it again. Now, it was very strange because they said at the show, we're looking for people to test them out. And I went online and it says that their timeline says it closes January 16th. And I thought, wait a minute, CES just closed 6 days ago.
Yeah,
why
exactly.
did they? But I went on and I was able to sign up. So it seems as though they realized themselves. So what they're looking for is 500 people in, I guess, death-defying sports. And if you're chosen, you get to wear one of these for 6 months. And you have to, I assume, fill out reports, or maybe they can just take all the info off the computer that's in your jacket. But I don't think playing Minecraft is probably not going to require one.
You know, sometimes I go and take out the trash, and that's a pretty extreme sport. But other than that, maybe playing with waffles. Not a lot.
Yeah, I have an idea you might not. That's why I didn't apply for one, because I thought walking to the marina was not going to be at the top of their list. I have the link there. I think it's the link is airrevolution.com.
Maybe. This is the in emotion.
It defaults over to that.
Right. And it's in I-N-E. M-O.
Oh, you know, if you just go to airbagrevolution.com,
does that work?
Airbagrevolution.com, it'll automatically go to this website.
Perfect. I can't imagine the amount of smarts in there, because I have seen so many extreme sports do things that I would assume kill me. And they're flipping around and doing all sorts of crazy stuff. There has to be some either simple, very simple solution that they could tell that you're not going to come back upright. Like, they could tell that you're peaking and you're not going to come back, after a fall. Or it has to be the most complicated thing I could ever think of, with like artificial intelligence and, you know, supercomputers. Like, that seems insane. So,
well, you know what? Maybe it's just that. The thing that goes on your wrist, it just is when your pulse says, oh my God, I'm going to die. The computer goes, now, he's scared stiff.
But see, wouldn't you get that same that's the thing, is if you're having the ride of your life and your pulse raises.
Oh, that's interesting.
You know,
that's
like, I can't imagine. It almost feels like a panic button is the best thing. I'm not going to make it. Panic button. Would be the best. But the other thing is that it doesn't seem all that intrusive if it goes off. It wasn't like that orb that James Bond had in that one movie that like completely encircled him. It just seems like kind of puffs it out so that
Land. You get out and you open the valve and
exactly.
I thought it was interesting. I thought it was very interesting that David Copperfield was so fascinated by it.
Wait a second. We need compressed air in a vest.
Yes.
This is what we need. Exactly. Very cool. Nemotion.com or airbagrevolution.com to find out more. It's interesting.
Okay. And our final guy we talked about on the show. So let's do the one-minute video. If you don't know about FoldyMate, this is what FoldyMate does. And then we'll show you our video. I think we met the inventor, right?
Yeah, I think this is the founder.
The founder. All right, so let's see the little one-minute video. If you don't know about FoldyMate that we did a few weeks ago, this is what FoldyMate does.
FoldyMate. Oh, is there no audio here? Audio go.
Oh, it's just music. Okay,
it's just music,
that's right.
So yeah, there's family. Yeah. There's dirty clothes everywhere.
No one wants to fold them. Except, wait a minute. Now we have a machine that looks like it has a Venetian blind on it, and to each slat we're attaching a freshly laundered but wrinkled garment. And now we're inside the machine, and arms are folding it. It's wrinkled, so now steam is spraying on it.
You got perfume.
Now it's sanitizing it, perfuming it.
And of course, you put this in the living room, of course. There we go.
Unless you have the luxury of, there you go. A door opens, everything's neatly folded. Did you have a laundry room, by the way, Chad?
I do. I'm lucky enough to have a whole room dedicated. Yes.
Oh, my word. Oh, my word. All right. So Chad and I were both very excited about this, and things were not as much fun as we thought. So let's run our little video.
Here is our video from CES and the Foldy Mate. And I got to turn that on.
Hey, we don't need any introduction. I'm Chad Johnson.
And I'm Dickie D. DeBartolo.
Oh, wait a minute. Dickie DeBartolo, the Giz Wiz and Mads Medis.
I have the red hair. I'm Chad Johnson.
Okay, so we did a whole show about Foldy Mate, okay? We were talking about, we were going to find it at CES. Chad and I found it. Chad and I each brought a whole bag of clean but unfolded laundry. And then we found out that the inventor of it is here, so it's not quite ready, but we're going to ask him if he would mind pressing our clothes for us since we made the trip.
Absolutely. I think that's only fair,
okay.
Really.
So now, when is this coming along? We told people they can buy, they can reserve one online.
Yes.
Okay. And is this what it's going to look like?
Yes, that's the mock-up version of FoldyMate. This is how we envision the product will look like when you have it at home. And it will be very easy to use it. I can show it to you later. And it will be available towards the end of 2018. And pre-orders will open up towards the end of this year, where we will do a product unveiling, and you could actually bring your laundry over.
Well, wait a minute. Where are you going to be? Are you going to come to my house? where is the unveiling?
We're doing an event, and you got an invite from us.
Yeah, I did, but where? Physically, where is it?
So West Coast and East Coast. We'll announce.
Oh, okay. Well, on each coast? Okay. I will not press or clean a garment until the fall of 2018.
Yeah.
So wrinkled clothes.
I do that anyway.
Yeah. Oh, he's right.
Yeah.
He's right.
Just to be accurate, we're de-wrinkling clothes, not ironing them.
We're de-wrinkling and folding them.
Folding it, of course.
Folding
it. But we said we can actually give you more bonus features like de-wrinkling. De-wrinkling is like 50% ironing. And we can also do fabric treatment, like softening and fragrance with specialized capsules. So you choose whatever you want to apply, you put it in the capsule, and FoldyMate will apply it on your fabric. So you could be like the guy who walks in the office and everyone like, what's that smell? This guy is doing laundry with FoldyMate.
This guy's very good. I think you should be in show business, not making things that fold laundry. All right, well, this is Dick DeBartolo.
And Chad Johnson.
And
we both smell anyway.
We're two working guys with wrinkled clothes until 2018 in the fall. Bye.
Bye. So that was FoldyMate. 2 years we're going to have to wait.
You know what? That is the furthest in the distance I have ever seen a product at CES.
Companies peak and then fall in 2 years. 2 years ago, Vine didn't exist. And now it doesn't. Yeah. It doesn't exist anymore now. That seems incredible.
So the only reason it still may happen is what the guy, I believe, is going to show us is something that I think I saw on their website, is that they currently make commercial units that do this. Giant, giant folding machines that do tons of folding laundry. So they have the technology to do it, and they want to get it down to that size. But it did seem strange that normally when you go, they say, at the end of the year, you can buy it. Here, at the end of the year, you can order it
right
and get it at the end of another year.
Yeah. Yeah. And that seems, I mean, I do have faith that this product will eventually exist because of the background of this company. And it seems like there was a lot of buzz around it. But you just got to think, it's like, that's not how a tech company works. In a modern day and age, people are iterating and making and doing, and this seems like they're going to Russia and then getting engineers to work on it, and then it has to come back, and then it seems like something is, are you talking to Lockheed Martin to make sure that you can make this Foldy Mate? Like, what's going on here?
And several people in the chat room pointed out he had a very wrinkled shirt.
He needed it. Now, should we move on? Because I found something else.
Oh, no, yeah,
concerning laundry robots, and it is called the Laundroid. So this Laundroid, this is actually found by our producer, Josh, and it does basically the same thing with some big differences. Its pre-orders will start in March of this year and should hopefully ship soon after. This is significantly larger. It is a much bigger product than the Folding Mate, and you can kind of see it in their photos here at the start. This, I think, this is the entire.
Oh
thing.
My God!
It's like an armoire. It's gigantic. It's pretty big. So yeah.
What does that sell for?
I don't know. Pre-orders will start in March. Now, the fact that pre-orders are starting in March makes me think that this product is going to exist a lot faster.
Yeah, the end of the year, right?
And they had a demo unit. There was a keynote with this product, and it seemed like it was actually working on stage. I'm trying to see if there's a
Yeah, I'd love to see what it physically looks like.
Right, exactly. Here, I may have to do some research. But yeah, so Panasonic has already invested in this product. So it has $60 million investment from Panasonic. The washer
$60 million?
Yep. These are all notes coming from Josh, our producer.
Holy cow.
The washer and dryer unit will be added by 2019, and it takes 5 to 12 minutes per article of clothing for the Laundroid. Pre-orders in March, and it was sort of shown at CES. I think they had a booth. I know that they did a keynote.
Oh, I didn't even know about this. Right. This is good. Josh, thanks for finding that.
Yeah, and so here's a video. This video is from the Japan Times. You can see the Laundroid over
this
there.
The thing is bigger than my bedroom.
Exactly. Well, no, okay, so the things on the side, those are just, armoires.
Oh, closets. Oh, okay. Closets. All right, so yes. It's the white... The white, okay,
that
I got
thing
it.
It's opening that up thing. Its mouth. Now this is interesting, right? She didn't hang it like the folding.
Oh yeah, you're right.
She just folded it up and threw it in that thing that looks an awful lot like HAL 9000.
Yeah.
And then it's doing its analysis. So then that would be the big advantage is that, and it seems like they're gearing up that you throw in dirty clothes and then out pop clean clothes. Because
I see. So
if there's a washer and dryer unit, right, it can and it will be able to use analysis to figure out the clothes before or when it's just in a pile of other clothes. So yeah, it does take a little while per device.
It does. That seems... it said 5 to 7 minutes. They hope to speed that up.
Right. And so there it is. There's the finished folded product. Seems like it's on some glass. She's put it on glass.
It is on glass.
Yeah, they may have slid that in there so she can hold it up. But
Okay.
But yeah,
I'm waiting for the Folding Mate.
Yeah, exactly. The Folding Mate does seem a little bit more consumer. This one seems a little bit
friendly.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, that's there are multiple versions of folding machines.
And that one was called the what again?
The Laundroid, like an Android, Laundroid. From Seven Dreamers. You can find out more at 7dreamers.com.
Okay. Now, you found something at CES yourself, right?
I did. So, I walked all over CES and I saw a lot of interesting stuff, but one thing really, really, really took it away for me. And I'm going to go ahead and just show some B-roll of what this is. And there we go. Here it is. So this Vingoo, V-I-N-G-O-O, is a vending machine, but it vends orange juice that it cuts and presses right in front of you. And I thought this was so interesting. So this would be in a mall or maybe a school, and you'd walk up, and there's a big touch screen over on the right-hand side, and you would say, how much you want, just a cup, and there it goes. After it's created, there's the cup, hand it to that lady. She already had a straw, but there's a straw in that little blue container. She just pulled out a straw right there. The Vingoo freshly squeezed orange juice machine. I thought that this was incredible. Now, there is a small problem with this gadget, is that it's not really quite a gadget. It's not for you and me, like the Folding Mate. This, when I asked them, price and availability, there's a $10,000 deposit, and then you pay per month for the service, and you're not really ever owning it, and all this crazy stuff. So it's much more, they were there at CES to find people who would work out a contract, and that they would.
Yeah, I noticed there were a couple of ice cream vendors there doing the same thing. In Eureka Park, there was a company selling pretzels that you shot through with ice cream. I mean, it was kind of a clever idea, but it was the same deal, rent the machine and rent a monthly service contract.
Right, exactly. But all in all, I think that this is just
a clever idea.
Super clever, super interesting. They were talking about some of the smarts and logistics behind it, in that it would know exactly how many oranges were in the tray, and it would notify personnel. This is all not in English, but it would notify personnel when it needed to be changed. And you could also determine exactly how many oranges were in each cup of juice. And I got to taste the juice, and it was really, really, really good. But also the fact that I had that big touchscreen and made it really, really, really nice. It really stood out as something very interesting. And also the first thing I thought of was, I remember back to my public school days when they took out all the vending machines. All the vending machines got taken away. They eventually replaced them, but only with healthy, quote, healthy drinks. I always thought it was so stupid because it was like Powerades and Gatorades that had the same amount of sugar as the sodas. But anyway, so this I thought would be, wow, what a cool thing to have at a school, is instead of sodas, orange juice. So that was my basic.
Oh, yeah, okay. I can picture someone going up and throwing a T-shirt in there and it coming out all orangey and said,
but
folded. Oh, no, you bought the wrong machine.
Exactly. I want one in my house. Just on-demand orange juice. Thank you very much.
Okay.
But, yeah, so that was, and once again, it's spelled a little weird, V-I-N-G-O-O. juice.com. Vingoo.
Spelled juice. Again, V-I-N?
V-I-N-G-O-O. Like Vingo,
okay.
Maybe.
Oh, okay.
Go. Yeah, exactly. So, anyway, that was the Vingoo orange juice distribution machine.
Okay.
And with that, I think it is.
We
time.
Go to your final Chad's Crappy Corner for January.
Corner. Get it.
Okay, so for this gadget, this is the last gadget of January. This actually kind of comes with a little bit of a backstory. This is called the leak alert. the leak alert. A little while back, I left my freezer door open. Everything melted, came into the kitchen. There was water everywhere. All the food had spoiled. And my parents had also had this issue. So for Christmas, they got me what is called the leak alert. Looks like this. And okay. This has some contacts on the back in order to tell when a leak is occurring to stop it before it does. The inside looks pretty simple, just like this. It uses a 9-volt battery to plug in. Go ahead and connect that. Now, what's interesting, it kind of has this little pocket down here at the bottom, and the battery will not. Jeez, that scared me. Okay, we get it. The battery
will... Oh, the battery, it doesn't reach?
It doesn't reach. It will not fit in there.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, why is it... Oh, maybe it's my finger. Maybe my finger is causing it to...
Your finger's touching the contact.
Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, you can see that it's very loud, and it definitely scared me. So then what you would do is you would set this on the ground in a corner near where, if there was a leak, that it would detect. I'm surprised. I'm trying to figure out if my finger caused that to happen. Yeah, it did. Wow, that's...
Yeah.
That was immediate. Yeah. Now, what I was going to do, but obviously we've already tested it, was I had a little bit of water here. So I was going to set the leak alert in it and then see how long it takes for the leak alert to kind of go off here. Let's go to product shot. I'm not sure if you can see kind of the water scooting in there. It's going to get to the contacts in just a little bit. There it goes.
Oh, okay.
Pretty instant.
Oh, but you have to be home.
You do have to be home.
Yeah.
So this is not really a smart device. Luckily, when pulling out of the water, it's a very fast shutoff because that is a very loud thing. So there, it doesn't connect with Bluetooth or Wi-Fi to alert you on your phone or anything like that. But if you're at the house and hear it going off, you'll know that something has sprung a leak. Now, I think my biggest criticism of it is that that sounds basically too much like a fire alarm. I think it needs to sound different in order to not confuse customers into thinking that that their fire alarm is going off. The other issue that my parents talked to me about, because they've had one of these, is that whenever the battery gets low, it makes the same sound. And I failed to ask if it was the same sound as a fire alarm, as it like beeps that deet deet, or if it sounds like it's going off, like it just starts wailing when its battery is low. But that was their complaint, that the sound when the battery gets low is annoying. Now,
and what's the name of that one?
This is the leak alert, water detector from Zircon.
Oh my gosh! Okay.
You know Zircon?
Yeah.
There it is. It's on Amazon. It's $12.60, and it's pretty simple. You know, at the end of the day, I'm gonna definitely set it next to my fridge to hopefully catch any other leaks. But you can see that they're giving a whole bunch of different options. Maybe near your hot water heater. Near a bathroom that springs a leak all the time, near a faucet. This doesn't seem super useful, but yeah, you can see that pretty simple device to make sure that leaks can be detected. I do kind of wish that the battery was a little bit, because now, I mean, I know this isn't a very mobile product, but the battery just kind of flops around in there, so... that'd be nice if that was a little bit better in there. So, yeah, that is the leak alert.
Very good.
I touched it. I touched the side of it. I think we need to pull the battery off. Oh, there is no one thing that I did like is that there is no screw to get the front plate off.
Okay.
It's just a quick removal of the front. It's just a nice... friction. Okay, so the leak alert, it's $12 on Amazon. This one I'd say is not so crappy. This wasn't that crappy of a gift. It seems to work, and I will put it to good use.
Excellent.
With that, let's jump into Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
On.
Okay,
and our video of the week is from a frequent contributor to the Giz Wiz, Moses Torres. And when I first saw a picture of it, I thought it was something from his gadget warehouse. And then I realized it's something being marketed today.
What?
And yeah, if you have old movies, watch this video. I never knew a gadget like this existed. So here we go. I can, he doesn't talk for about 30 seconds, so I can talk over it. I didn't know what I was watching. I thought this was some old 8mm film editing bay. But it actually is a device available today at B&H and on Amazon for $300. But what it is doing is digitizing 8mm film or Super 8.
Wow.
A frame at a time.
That looks super slick. And now slick. I think,
yeah, and Moses starts, I think, talking here.
Very cool. That, I thought that was just like a normal, wow, look at that rewind function.
Rewinding.
I thought that was just one of those screens that was like a mirror.
This is a device I wanted to share with you. You just saw it working and rewinding. This is the Wolverine Film to Digital Movie Maker device that allows you to transfer in the background. That's one of the transfers I made. It allows you to transfer 8 and Super 8 millimeter film. Those are the ones that transferred. To SD card.
Wow.
It has these two reels. These are the largest size you can put on. And it transfers it, like I said, to an SD card in 720p at 30 frames per second. And it does a pretty decent job. I got it at B&H for $300. And this is everything that comes inside the box, and I'm very happy with it. Oh, except the SD card. That doesn't come with the device. You have to buy that separate. But anybody that's looking to transfer film, 8mm, it's pretty good. It's a little rough on the cut. I had some jams when I guess my dad had repaired some of the film when it got stuck in the old projector. And that had some issues, so you had to pay attention a little bit. And, you know, you had to move the reel because it's not very good with that. But if you don't have any issue, it comes out pretty good, as you can see.
That's amazing.
On the screen. Okay. Enjoy. Bye.
Wow. I love that. Love that.
Now, I looked on their website, Wolverine's website. It has TV out. So after you make a video... record to an SD card. You can use the SD card to watch on your television, but it's an RCA jack out, so it's not going to be a great video. It also has a USB out, so you can, I guess, scan to your computer. And there was, if you're going to buy one, if you buy it at B&H Photo, read the reviews on Amazon, because I noticed that a lot of people said when it pulls the film through one frame at a time, the supply reel tends to start to unwind. And a lot of people on Amazon made little videos to show you how to insert a simple piece of cardboard between the machine and the reel that actually acts as a buffer so that the film feeds in much more evenly than if you let it do it by itself. So it's just using a piece of cardboard, but it's a great little workaround to get a more stable video. Yeah, there it is. Exactly. There it is. Someone just put an OakTag folder between the reel and the device, and that kept the film from unwinding. I mean, I never dreamed there was such a thing.
Yeah, I mean, I've known that they exist, but not for the consumer market. You know, I know that digitizing Super 8 and 8 millimeter exists.
Oh, I mean, I sent tons of my videos to a company called Yes Video, and they did a great job. But if you have tons of stuff, this is a way to, just do it all at home.
Yeah, exactly. Now, you know, someone in the chat room says, what if you have 16 millimeter wide? Well, just buy two.
Oh, no, cut the 16 in half.
Yeah, cut the 16 in half. There you go. No.
There you go. And just do it half at a time.
I'm kidding. Yeah, very interesting. I'm looking at Wolverine's website right now. It looks like, you know, this is a very, very new product for them. They have sort of some other converters here. What's interesting is these are all slides. So these are 20 megapixel slide things. This is the first thing they've done in with film. Oh, look at this. And a photo digitizer as well. So this is cool. And yeah, I know people who have 16 millimeter and other millimeter sizes. That'd be so neat if they went into that.
Yeah. I mean, I thought 8 millimeter and 8 millimeter and Super 8 were so far in the past that no one would come out with a new gadget to digitize it at home. But I guess people have tons of these films from, like Moses was saying, it's videos from films from his father.
Now, this is Bleak in the chat room gave us another version. This is $1,299.
Does it fold shirts?
It does not. And it won't be available until 2018. But so you can see the kind of the competition.
What? Oh, my word. Look at this.
Right. That
So that actually, you project the film and it makes a video image?
I can't tell. Image mode, super image. No, this is just a, it looks a lot like a projector, but it is just a recorder.
A recorder, okay. Right. Boy, amazing.
But still, that one cost $1,200. This one from Wolverine cost $300.
$300
doable. I know plenty of people who, to save the memories from the past, are going to throw down $300 in order to pull that off. Absolutely. So very cool. Very, very cool.
So Moses, thank you very much for telling us about a category no one knew about. You get the February Mad and an Alfred E. Newman picture. And we're looking for more videos. Pretty much anything unique. I mean, like, this is a unique gadget. So if you found a gadget no one knows about, make a 2 to 3 minute video of that. If you bought something that was a piece of crap, make a video about that. And of course, if you have something in the garage, in the kitchen drawer that hasn't been seen in years, make a video of that. Put it on YouTube. Click unlisted. That lets only a person with the URL to see it. And send that URL to us. And if we show it on the show, you get a Mad Magazine, one of those 35-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures, assuming you live in the U.S. or Canada. If you don't and we show it, we will give you a shout-out on the show. And it goes to mail@gizwiz.tv, just like it is there, mail@gizwiz.tv. And we're running out of video, so please send us one soon, especially new viewers who haven't sent us something. It's so easy.
So easy. You have a camera in your pocket. It's amazing.
Exactly. Just use, if you're using your phone, horizontal, please.
Yes. None of this. Keep it like this. Thank you.
That's it. That's it. That's all we ask.
Absolutely. Okay, so that was quite a nice gadget warehouse. With that, let's jump into the letter.
La 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 la
when I was looking for a letter when I saw the subject line, picture of Chad.
What?
I had to pick that letter, and then I read the letter, but we'll still use it. Here's a picture of a woodpecker that started coming to our squirrel-proof bird feeder. My wife immediately named the woodpecker Chad for obvious reasons. Signed, Ken and Marie Kovar, proud Patreons of the Giz Wiz.
Oh, my God.
That, you know, I never realized woodpeckers had.
I didn't either. I tend to not see red, you know, or woodpeckers at all where I'm at. That's pretty funny.
That is funny. So there is Chaddy Woodpecker.
Chad the Woodpecker.
I've been
immortalized as a bird.
yeah, there you go.
That's quite amazing. That is very funny. Yeah. Thank you for the image.
Thank you, Ken and Marie. That was great. That's great.
And their patrons, hey! We want to give a big thank you to our patrons right now. Patreon.com is a place for you to support independent content creators. And our Patreon page is patreon.com/gizwiz. We, for the month of January, so this is the last time this month, we're giving away some old gadgets to our patrons. And normally we let them pick the crappy corner theme, but this month we're giving them stuff for free. So this is what they're getting. The VR mask, virtual reality viewer. We did this on the under $5 episode.
Oh, yeah. You know what? That was in CVS for $20.
Yeah.
At Christmas.
You can get it at Five Below for a little bit less. I actually ended up kind of liking
this
one.
And it looks good, too.
I know. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this. there is a way to pop the... There you go. How do I look? Can you see?
Oh, great.
Hey.
Great,
yeah.
Your new bifocals are in there.
Exactly.
Neat.
Let me just read some of these. Oh, man. Whoa, this box is in 3D. Holy mackerel. So this is the virtual reality viewer. Works with almost all phones, and it's kind of a fun thing to have around and show off. So who wins this virtual reality viewer? By the way, it does still come with a little bit of alcohol, a prep pad. I would consider using this when you get it to your house. I'll leave that for the viewer who wins. And the winner is Shepard Sachiff from New York. Shepard Sachiff, S-C-H-I-F-F. From New York, thank you so much for participating and being a patron. And you will be getting the virtual reality viewer. So you too don't have to live in real reality like the rest of us. And once again, a big thank you to our patrons, patreon.com/gizwiz. You guys really make the show happen every single week, especially in these times. In January, nobody buys ads. Ain't nobody buying ads. And even if we had an ad every show, the way that you guys support us on Patreon is really the only way that we can continue working. So thank you so much to our 294 patrons. You guys are absolutely fantastic.
Working our way to 300.
Almost there. It'll be great to have 300 patrons. Absolutely. Thank you so much.
How about if they don't want to give monthly?
If you don't want to give monthly, we have an option for you. You can head on over to gizwiz.tv. Click on the Patreon tab, but don't be fooled, because right underneath the Patreon banner, there is a PayPal link. And some people, they don't want to give every single time we do a show. They just want to give us one lump sum. And that's the way to donate and support the show, with that PayPal link right there. And big thanks to everyone who supports that.
Yes, this is our 91st show sponsored by Patreon.
We're going to hit 100 soon. Very soon.
I would say like in another 9 shows.
I would, I guess. I'm not that great at math, but I'm more of a host than a mathematician. But I would hope so. Thank you guys so much for supporting us on Patreon. Before we go, make sure that you head on over to gizwiz.biz and check out What the Heck Is It? That's the game where we see gadgets, but don't know exactly what they're for. This is a real gadget. This is a whole gadget, and it does something. I'm not gonna lie, it does something. I'm thinking that this is a automatic nail file. This is a very blunted nail file right here. It's a new age type of product. I really have no idea what the heck that thing is. But if you do, there's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, 24 for the funny, hilarious, clever, and interesting answers. So you got to use your brain to come up with a use for what this thing could be and win a Mad Magazine. And make sure you check out the show live. We should be at the same time, same day, same place for the next Thursday's months, for about a month and a half. okay. I said this famously two episodes ago, and then, of course, here we are recording the day early. For the next foreseeable month, we're all going to be here. That is at 4:30 Pacific time, about 7:30 Eastern time, and you can watch us live at gizwiz.tv. When you're there, please subscribe to the show, join the chat room, and check out our show notes there at gizwiz.tv.
And if there's ever a change, it's always at the top of gizwiz.tv.
Yep.
If you're saying, oh, are they doing it Thursday this week? Just go to gizwiz.tv, and right at the top it says normal nice week banners.
There we are. There we are live. There we are. There's the
update.
Banners.
Chaz got a gig Thursday.
Exactly.
I didn't know it was PAX when I posted that, but there you go.
And also, I think that somebody comes into the chat room and does it. If you join irc.gizwiz.tv, then it'll actually say it as, hey, we're recording Wednesday at the usual time. I don't know who updates that. Maybe it's Beatmaster. That's fantastic.
Probably Beatmaster. Beatmaster is a behind-the-scenes genius.
Yeah, he's great. He's absolutely fantastic to have. That about wraps it up for this episode of the Giz Wiz. Thanks so much for watching and supporting, and we'll see you next time.
I'll be here.